pillars facing around 200 million people. Secondly, looking not only the population, even the nature of the population, a population that has been dominated by youth. And I think this is very relevant to our country. And if we get it right and we get the support of all stakeholders in the next few years, we'll all be proud of our country.
Okay, you described the National Digital Economic Policy and Strategy, I'm going to quote you, as a world is conceived on track and built on objectives that will boost development of digital skills in both private and public sectors. And Nigerians are making their mark globally.
Yeah.
So what way are you, you know, harnessing the skills of these young men out there who globally are coming out to say, we can do this and Nigeria can move forward digitally? How do you enhance the skills?
I think we have many activities that we are supporting youth in this country when it comes to digital economy. Looking at our population and a population that has been dominated by youth, however, looking at the constraint of resources could not be enough. And we need to at least get more support of the federal government so that we will be able to accommodate many youth. However, recently, if you could recall, during this COVID-19 pandemic, we introduced what we call virtual academy. Two virtual institutions, number one in the ministry and number two at the National Information Technology Development Agency. In this process, youth are encouraged to enroll into the program, acquire digital skills.